The following program is a production of HEW Entertainment and contains views, opinions, commentaries, and content that may offend some subscribers of this show. Listener's discretion is advised.
If you have an opinion on our show, let us know what you have to say through the power of social media.
Man, I am so excited about this. This is going to be so much fun.
Picture me without you, but I can't, 'cause we could be immortals.
Jonathan Clark is a legend. Everyone's realized that. And everyone I think is a Jonathan Clark fan, they just don't admit to it. When my time comes, I just hope that everyone remembers who I was, and that was really just Jonathan Clark.
Picture me without you, but I can't, 'cause we could be immortal.
Bust the fuck up, I'm your host Jonathan Clark, and as you can probably tell, it's been a rough few weeks for me. I broke the olecranon bone in my left elbow about 2 weeks ago. I've still got 4 weeks to go in a cast, but I thought I would update you on what my life has been like over the last several days since the break, which happened about 17 days ago back from today. It was kind of a scary experience for me, so for those of you who have been wondering where I've been, what became of me, it's pretty much just a recovery process for me from here on out. I was actually admitted to the hospital a couple of nights ago. I was admitted for over 24 hours. Following emergency surgery on my left elbow, the olecranon bone was completely separated and broken. But I want to just let everybody know that I'm doing okay, and I should. I'm expected to make a full recovery. I'm getting staples out after about 5 through 10 staples. We're putting my elbow. I'm going to be getting staples out on the 19th of the month. There, I'm going to be spending 4 weeks in a cast after going from a back slab, but it's been rough, and you can only imagine in your mind what I've gone through. I know there are people out there that have gone through worse, but I just want to update everybody on what's been going on in my life, what's been happening, because I've been known to document everything that's happened in my life, anything critical that's happened, anything major. So it would be unlike me, uncharacteristic of me, if I didn't update you on how I've been feeling and what's been going on. So for those of you who have been wondering, probably had some concern, that's what's been pretty much up with me over the last several weeks, at least for the last two. It's been quite difficult doing everyday things. A daily routine has been very difficult for me. So you can only imagine how difficult it's been for me to get updates posted on my website, but I will get around to doing that, and I will get back to a regular update routine once the recovery process is finished. Again, I broke my olecranon bone in my left elbow, which is the main elbow, which is the main bone in your elbow, which actually allows you to operate your elbow. And without surgery, which was immediate for me, I would have been unable to use my left elbow in my arm. I wouldn't have been able to use my left arm entirely because of the break and how it actually happened. And it was just because I just went out for a walk, really, is all that happened. And as you can tell, they put a huge cast on me, a bigger cast than what I had expected. Of course, it had to do with swelling. And that's why they put on such a huge cast. The good news is, though, the second cast that I'll be in for the upcoming 4 weeks will be smaller than this one, and I believe it's going to be a fiberglass cast they're going to be putting me in, so it's going to be easier for me to actually have mobility in the arm. I'm going to be able to use it more than what I am able to do right now, and as I said, you know, you can only imagine how difficult it is for me every day. It seems to be more difficult with this huge cast on, and that had to do with swelling because they sized the cast to the swelling of my arm. But again, you know, I just wanted to let everybody know how I've been feeling. It's been rough over the last couple of days. This is the second time in 2 years I've had surgery. The first time I had surgery was actually on my hand for one of my small fingers, on my right hand, on my right side. And now we go over to the left side and broke the entire elbow, and actually have lost functionality in my arm for now. I had minimal functionality in my arm right now because of the break in the elbow, because of how important your elbow is. And you don't realize how important things like your elbow bones are. That little bone in your elbow, you would never believe. That actually is the bone that actually allows you to operate your arm and have full functionality in your arm. But that's pretty much what happened to me, and I'm just trying to make a full recovery from it and just been trying to take it easy over the last couple of days. And I think that's been the difficult thing for me, trying to adjust to, you know, slowing it down and not having such a fast-paced life like I've been used to do. And I've never really been used to not doing anything. I've been just used to, you know, doing everyday things as each day comes. So, you know, trying to slow it down, I think, has been the most difficult thing for me. It's been really hard for me trying to slow it down and get used to not putting weight on the arm, you know, readjusting to using one hand as opposed to two. But again, the good news is I will be able to use both arms and both hands within the next 4 to 5 weeks. They're saying it could be on a little bit longer than 4 weeks, which is the allotted amount of time for the elbow to heal. But again, because I'm diabetic and I've been battling that for my entire life, for at least the last 19 years of my over 30 years of existence, they're going to keep the cast on, I would imagine, for a little bit longer than what actually a normal individual would have it on for. But again, the good news is I will make a full recovery. And it's now that I have even more respect than I've ever had for all the wrestlers who go through these huge therapeutic procedures following surgeries and major injuries. Because I understand and know, I've always known how difficult it's been for them, but I have a greater appreciation for that now that I've had something similar happen to me. Maybe not as severe as an injury that of a Seth Rollins or a Stone Cold Steve Austin or an Edge or a Chris Benoit who had neck injuries, knee injuries, but I do have a huge amount of respect for those guys and everything they've gone through, and a greater appreciation for them after having documented their injuries. I've been spoken to many of them over the years, or at least the last 18 years that I've been doing this. From 1999 up to 2017, I had the pleasure of sitting down with so many individuals and doing so many radio interviews. And I have a greater appreciation for everything they've had to go through and endure. But the good news is I will be making a full recovery, and hopefully things will get back to a bit of a normality pace for me over the next couple of weeks. Again, you can only imagine from your perspective and point of view what I've had to go through and what I've had to deal with. But I just wanted to update you guys on what's been going on with my life, because I've been known to document everything that's happened in my life, every critical moment, every pivotal point that I've gotten to in my life. I've documented again there one more time. You can see the cast, how huge the cast is. You can only imagine, put in perspective for yourself, how huge the swelling was. It was almost like I had a Hercules-sized arm and hand on the left side of my arm, and it was just very unorthodox. It was very difficult for me to get used to, but the good news is after about a week and a half, the swelling went down again. How that injury was sustained was actually on my way back home from a walk. I didn't make it home, actually. I made it home after the break. I didn't make it home in one piece, but I made it home after the break. I don't know how, after three attempts of trying to stand up, I was able to make it home, but I did make it home, and the good news is now I'm on the road to recovery. How long that will take, it's expected to be a little bit over 4 weeks. It could be longer, but I will update you again through the process as it gets closer to the removal of this cast and I go through therapy and get full functionality back in the left side of my body and the left side of my arm. It was just a horrible break. It was just a smash, people called it. I want to thank everybody who assisted with the surgery. I want to thank everybody who was a part of that. I made it a comfortable experience for me. Of course, I was put under anesthetic. I had to go to sleep for that. It was very, you know, challenging for me to have to go through with that, because it has a mental effect on your mind, a mentality effect on your mind. You know, a lot of stuff runs through your mind, and they made it very comfortable for me. I think it was a great experience for me, getting the chance to meet the people that I had the chance to meet through the breaking of this elbow. I didn't want to meet them under the circumstances that I did. It wasn't really a memorable experience meeting them under the circumstances that I had the chance to meet them under. But it was a great experience for me, getting the chance to speak to people who had even more severe injuries and things to deal with than what I did. And it just really put into perspective for me, you know, how no matter how bad you have it, someone's always got it worse. And that kind of thing happens every single day. It's something that you would think that we would all be used to, but we never do get used to it, because we don't expect it to happen to us. We say to ourselves, you know, that will never happen to me. When we see someone dealing with something so severe, like a crippling injury or some kind of surgery, like open heart surgery, the thing is, we say it's never going to happen to us, but we're never so sure, and we don't know what's going to happen to us from day in and day out. So we really have to take, every day as it comes and take it for what it's worth and really respect the fact that we're given the chance to live one more day here on this earth. And we say to ourselves all the time, it can never happen to me. But when you least expect it, something that you would never think would happen to you usually does. And that's what happened to me. So I want to thank everybody who was a part of this, who helped me on the road to recovery. And I want to thank you for showing your support. You probably don't know right up until now, at least until this video gets released, that this happened to me. But I want to thank everybody who showed their support for me, and I want to let you know that everything is okay. And like the first time I had surgery 2.5 years ago in September of 2015, I believe is when I had the first surgery that, or the second surgery that I had in my life, for the third time in about 10 years I've undergone surgery, and I want to let everybody know that I will be okay and things will get back to somewhat of a normality pace in due time. Until then, I'm your host, Jonathan Clark, and I will talk to you again really soon. So long for now.
HEW Entertainment Radio is a production of HEW Entertainment on their official website and broadcasts on social media. You can join the conversation on our Facebook page at HEW Entertainment, follow and listen to our show on Twitter at JonathanClark1, and watch us on our YouTube channel at JonathanClark22. Hosted and produced by Jonathan Clark out of Canada, if you have any questions on our radio broadcast, you can email us at JonathanClark2005@hotmail.com. Thank you for listening.